Pokémon Go, the game that brings nerds from all walks of life outside for the first time. In the game, Pokeballs are mysterious spherical cases that have the ability to trap Pokémon. The word trap is used very lightly here and can mean a number of different things. It could turn the Pokémon's mass into energy, which would be a lot, and by a lot I mean 500 quadrillion joules, or the amount of energy the Earth receives from the Sun in a whole hour. Or in terms us nerds know, about 36 trillion gallons of Mountain Dew and 28 trillion pounds of Doritos. If you've seen videos or read blogs about Pokeballs, you've likely come across people saying the mass is converted into energy, blah blah blah. This is false. There is no mass to energy alchemy going on here because mass is simply a property of energy. E equals mc squared doesn't tell you how much energy mass has, it tells you how much mass energy has. That's why Einstein originally wrote it like this. I know this is probably either mind-blowing or mind-numbing, depending on what you thought you were getting yourself into when you clicked on the clickbait title, but stick with me for a second. If you have two identical clocks, but one is ticking and one is not, the ticking clock actually has more mass. All of the potential kinetic and thermal energy within actually adds to the mass of the clock through E equals mc squared. But because the speed of light is so fast and it's being squared, the extra mass recorded is extremely tiny. For more on this, check out this awesome video by PBS SpaceTime. Now that we have that fallacy out of the way, we can look at Pokeballs more as mystical objects and less like physics-breaking animal-killing machines. In a previous video, we talked about how humans could respawn, and in that video, the question came up about what makes you, you. This is still one of the major mysteries of life, but there's no indication that if a Pokemon were to be broken down into its fundamental particles, that it could be reorganized into a living, breathing Pokemon once again. Assuming you could reorganize the atoms back into the original form and it would be a living, breathing Pokemon once again, how could you sort the whole body into a Pokeball? What if you could break down the body into water and non-water components? This would immediately reduce the amount of volume a Pokeball would need to be. When revitalizing the Pokemon, just add water. It isn't the most elegant method, but it would work, right? Here's the problem. The amount of information you need to store the location, type, and state of every atom contained within a Pokemon would not only be a lot, it would be nearly infinite. Atoms are made up of subatomic particles in a universe that is non-deterministic and probabilistic. In layman terms, basically you can't know exactly where an electron is, only the probability where it could be. Even if you were 99.999999% sure where every electron was, in a Pokemon like Pikachu, with 40 septillion atoms, the chance of you getting every atom correct is virtually zero. No, literally. When you type this into almost any mathematics program, you get zero. But for those curious, it's 1 over 10 to the 16 quadrillion. You have a better chance to win the lottery a million times straight, get 1,000 royal flushes in a row, then get attacked by a Rampidash, than you do to reconstruct a Pokemon in the non-deterministic universe. What if the Pokeball is made of antimatter and it annihilates the matter like the Death Star did in my previous Star Wars video? Maybe it could... When you're having to use real-life physics to explain a planet-destroying death ball to explain how a Pokeball works, I think you're starting to go too far. Listen, I love Pokemon Go as much as the next guy. Hell, I love it as much as everyone, but the Pokeball cannot, will not, ever exist in our known universe. It just can't be done. Which is why I believe that not only is Pokemon World not Earth, it isn't even a planet in our universe. It exists in a universe that has a different set of rules and a different set of physics. That was exhausting.